So children, the major difference between plants and animals is their motility. We all know that animals locomote whereas plants cannot locomote. But a very common point between both plants and animals is they both show movements. But where in plants, the movements are restricted only to certain parts, in case of animals, the movements are observed all over the body. So if you see, the animal body can be relocated from one place to another, whereas a plant cannot do. So you can now imagine that the movement of the animal body is not simply brought by some cells, but it is by a special group of cells which form a special kind of tissue, which is called as muscular tissue. Muscular means muscle, which is going to help or is responsible for bringing out various kinds of movements. Now, when I say that muscles are responsible for bringing various kinds of movements, not all the movements of the body are being observed or maybe seen. But yes, definitely you may be able to feel them. So, based on what kind of movements are brought and where they are brought and how is the structure, your muscles are again divided into three categories. But before we move on to the various three categories of muscle tissues, let us just see what are these, how do these muscle cells look like. Mostly these are elongated, fiber-like, and they bring out movements in various parts of the body. And as I said, as they are responsible for movement of the various parts of the body, that means we are stretching out our body. When you just raise your arms and raise your legs, it is meant that you are stretching your body. When you do your regular exercises, your body stretches, and this stretching is in the fibrous structures of the muscle cells. And this is all is brought about by special kind of proteins called as contractile proteins, which help in stretching or elongation of the muscle cells, not only in contraction but also in expansion and as well as in relaxation. So this combined contraction and relaxation of the muscles is responsible for the movement of your body parts. So depending upon where they are located, the structure and their function, muscle cells are of three main categories. Now, we are able to move our arms and limbs, our arms and legs, that is the forelimbs and the hind limbs. And this is brought by the special kind of muscles which are called as skeletal muscles. Now, here in the given image, you are able to see the skeletal muscles. So, by seeing the image, I hope you can understand how the structure appears like. Yes, it is cylindrical. Now, the blue marking indication, what you are able to see, those are nothing but your nucleus. And how many nucleus you are able to observe in one cylindrical structure? Yes, more than one. So cylindrical, multi-nucleated, multi-many. So there are more than one nucleus present in each of this cylindrical structure. And if you see, they are lying one below the other, closely packed up. So that means they are just attached, but they are not branched. And where they are very often, where they are found at the joints around your bones. So that is why these are also called as skeletal muscles. Now, can you move your hands and legs on your own? Yes, as and when you wish, you will stop your movement of your arms, you may stop the movement of your legs. So you see that these movements are under your control. That is why these muscles are also termed as voluntary muscles, voluntary on your own, which are controlled by our body. But then there are also certain movements which are not under our control. And the very most important movement which you cannot control, or which you don't even like to control, is the movement of your heart or the heart beat. Yes, and so there are another special type of muscles which are located in and around your heart. Now observe carefully the skeletal muscle and the muscles in and around your heart. Now the muscles which are located in and around your heart are termed as cardiac muscles. Cardia means heart. So observe the structure of both these muscles, children. You can see some similarity and as well as some dissimilarity. Now, what is the major visible similarity between them? Yes, they are also cylinder-like. And then, of course, they also contain nucleus, but nucleus in skeleton are many. But in case of your cardiac, you can see hardly one or maybe two. And then You see, one of the cylindrical muscle is connected to another cylindrical muscle. So they are branched. In case of your skeleton, they are unbranched, but here they are branched. And one more similarity, if you are able to see, they are going to show, you are able to see some light and dark patterns. So these are called as striations. So these striations are observed both in case of skeletal muscle and cardiac muscle. It is because of the presence of these striations, skeleton muscles are also referred as striated muscles. Coming to cardiac, they are also cylindrical as in case of skeletal muscles, but then these movements are not under our control. So you cannot control the heart beat, or the, what is a heartbeat? The heartbeat is nothing but the pumping of blood by your heart. So how this blood is being pumped? It is due to the contraction and relaxation of the heart, which is brought by the cardiac muscles. Then coming to the third category, other than heart, the movements of the internal organs like your digestive system, or the movement of your the respiratory system, that is your lungs or the windpipe, and even your excretory system, are brought by special type of muscle cells which you cannot control, which are directly under the control of the system itself. Hence, these are also called as involuntary. In means not under your control. Now observe their structure. Their structure is entirely different from that of the skeletal, or for that matter even cardiac muscles. Here they are more or less spindle shaped. And how many nucleus are present? Only one. So uninucleated. And do they show that the dark and light patches? No. So they are unstriated, and of course they would be branched. So since the striations are not observed, we also call them as what? Smooth muscles. So here children, so today we learnt about the types of muscle cells, that is a skeletal, cardiac and smooth muscles.